Okie dokie.
All right. Pops, the destined return of Young Lion Pops has been bestowed upon you. Sadly, there's a vague missing space here. Not sure what's going on there. But maybe we'll figure it out.
He did put up that short, what was that, a couple weeks ago?
Yeah, I've seen that.
So other than that short, CJ is like MIA, he's missing in action. We don't know for sure where he's at. I put up a short, and you put up that short.
Yeah, I was running, dude. That was horrifying.
And so you was able to make your way out of the woods, and then CJ put, I don't know if he was like on a cruise or where he was.
He was like, kicked back.
He was like just kicking back, enjoying life. I heard he was out in Vegas or doing some shit out there. I don't know.
Maybe. Oh, was he like gambling?
I don't know. He could be on a bender for all I know. But like maybe he'll fill us in if he ever returns. Buddy, you're always welcome back. So we got this space right here for you when you want to come back, man.
It's all for you, buddy. But so since we don't have him, Pop said, Bud, you know, now that you're finally found, let's make some videos. People have been asking. So I have brought up on a Fall Out Boy, I Don't Care song. I'm a big fan of this one. I don't know if, have you heard this one?
I don't think so. I've heard Fall Out Boy, but not.
Okay. I think this one's pretty catchy. It's just kind of funny. It's just kind of like one of those, like, you literally just don't care videos. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Other than that, I think I'm ready to jump right in. You ready, Pops?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's see what we got.
So far, I hate the song.
Why do you hate this?
I mean, the words ain't too bad, but like this is not like hard hitting at all. You feel like this is like a good workout song? What do you feel?
Well, no, not a good workout song.
You just like listen to it, like
yeah, I like just listen to it. Like I didn't listen to it on the way here, but like if I'm cruising down the interstate or whatever, and this came on, I'd be like, all right, yeah.
You turned it up.
I don't know if I'd necessarily
turn that up.
I wouldn't go that far, but. I would maybe like a notch or two. Come on, guys. You guys like this one, don't you? I'm not going to change it. Yeah. I think this song is like catchy. I think it's just like kind of a fun little song.
I think there are some Fall Out Boy songs I like, but this ain't one of them. All right. Let's finish it out.
Okay. said in the middle of the song you weren't feeling it. What's going on there?
Nothing really changed. I do think, like, when he got towards the end, they kind of switched up, like, the cadence. It all almost reminded me, I was, like, getting, like, this idea, like, those guys back in, like, the 40s and 50s, like, wearing, like, those zoot suits, and they're, like, snapping
Yeah, okay.
It was kind of, a little jazzy right through there a little bit, but, overall, though, I wasn't digging it at all. I don't see what you would like about it, actually. I mean, it's not, like, I don't, like, hate it, but it's, like, it's just, like, a nothing song to me. It doesn't really move me one way or the other. It doesn't make me, like, oh, turn that shit off, but it isn't, like, it ain't, like, turn it up either, you know what I mean?
Yeah, okay. I get that. Well, clearly they don't care as long as you're thinking about it. So, yeah.
And we are talking about it right now.
So, I'm pretty sure they're on the winning side. I think this song's pretty catchy, and the guy, Patrick Stump, like the main singer fella, dude, that dude, I saw him in concert last year, that dude, immaculate, he can sing, he gets it out there, he's a kid.
Was he wearing a suit suit?
He was not, he was wearing like a dad outfit, like pretty much what you're wearing right now. I don't know, I think it's pretty good, it's catchy, I wouldn't say it's a workout song like you said though.
Yeah.
So. What would you rate this?
I would have to give this a 3.
A 3. That is actually worse than I thought you were gonna say. I'm giving the song a strong like 7.5. It's up there. I think it's a banger. So is that okay?
That's the difference between Gen X and Gen Z. Gen X and Gen Z.
You got it in the description. I'd have to look.
I know I'm Gen X. So that's the difference in musical taste right there.
Well, there you have it.